This is the second video of my video series on running a regression using SPSS. In the previous video, I discussed how to identify and deal with outliers. In this video, I discuss how to test for normality assumption in regression. This is one of the important and frequently misunderstood assumptions in regression analysis. For example, we can frequently see people checking normality of individual variables. However, this assumption refers to the multivariate normality of the variables. Anyway, simply speaking, normally distributed data has a bell-shaped histogram where most of the observations are concentrated in the center while very few observations are located in the two tails. Here we can see two variables with multivariate normality. I do not intend to discuss the properties of a normal distribution in detail here. However, what is important for us in a regression analysis is to have the residuals normally distributed. In other words, we need to ensure that the error term is normally distributed. If this assumption is violated, the statistics generated by the regression, like the p-values, confidence intervals, and the insights obtained may be misleading. For example, this makes it difficult for us to decide whether a coefficient is zero or significantly different from zero. In this demonstration, I use this data set to test the normality in a regression analysis. This is a deliberately prepared data set which nicely fits with this regression model. For example, the regression coefficient should be 4 for credit risk, 2 for leverage, and 1.5 for size. If the regression analysis is capable of estimating these coefficients from the dataset, we can say that the regression results are accurate. Okay, first I will show how to generate residuals. Actually, we are interested in standardized residuals in this case. We can save these standardized residuals into our dataset when we run the regression. First, click Analyze, Regression, Linear. In the dialog box, move the dependent variable into dependent and the independent variables into independent. Then click Save. In this dialog box, I select Standardized under Residuals. Then click Continue. Then click OK here. Now we can see that a new variable containing residuals has been added to our dataset. These are the standardized residuals of our regression. Then we generate histogram and normal probability plot with relevant test to see whether this newly added variable in our dataset is normally distributed. For this, first click Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and Explore. In this dialog box, select our residual variable and move it to dependent list. Then click Plots and click checkboxes for histogram and normality plots with tests like this. Then click Continue. Under Display here, make sure that both is selected. Then click OK. In this histogram, we can see that our residuals are approximately normally distributed. This QQ plot also indicates approximate normality since almost all data points are fitted nicely with this line. In addition to this visual observation, statistical tests for normality such as Kolmogorov and Smirnov test and Shapiro and Wilk test provide more precise information about normality. If these tests are significant, the variable is not normally distributed, because the null hypothesis in these two tests is the variable is normally distributed. For example, in this case, both of the tests are statistically not significant since the p-values are greater than the critical values. Higher p-values do not allow us to reject this null hypothesis. This implies that the residuals are normally distributed. At the same time, we can see in our previous regression results that all our regression coefficients are statistically significant. Importantly, they are almost equal to the expected values. This indicates that the regression analysis has accurately estimated the coefficients. Anyway, please note that In practical cases, we do not know the expected value. Therefore, in practical cases, we take the results as accurate if all the assumptions are met, like in this case. Actually, we can generate this normal probability plot while running the regression as well. For this, we can click Analyze, Regression, and Linear. In the dialog box, move the dependent variable into dependent and the independent variables into independence as we did before. Then click Plots and select Histogram and Normal Probability Plot under Standardized Residuals. Then click Continue. Then click OK here. Now we can see this histogram and normal probability plot. However, with this method, we cannot see normality test results and we cannot do further analysis on the residuals. Therefore, I prefer to save the residuals first as illustrated earlier and then separately analyze the residuals for diagnosing the problems. Next, let's look at the case where the residuals are not normally distributed. For this purpose, I use this variable named credit risk with outliers instead of this credit risk. This new variable contains 3 outliers while all other 147 observations remain the same. First, let's save the residuals in our dataset while running the regression. Now, let's generate histogram, normal probability plot, normality test, and box plot for residuals. Here, the histogram looks skewed. Further, we can see that the tests are statistically significant, indicating the fact that the residuals are not normally distributed, because significant p-values compel us to reject this null hypothesis. Further, we can observe that despite the statistical significance of the model and coefficients, some of the coefficients have deviated substantially from the expected values. This implies that the regression analysis has failed to accurately estimate the coefficients this time. Importantly, large increases in the p-values can also be seen here if we increase the number of decimal places. For illustration, I converted p-values into scientific format. In fact, violation of this assumption signals the existence of other problems such as inaccuracy of the model or violation of one or more other assumptions. Among these, one of the very common reasons for violation of this normality assumption is outlier. Therefore, when this assumption is violated, it is a good idea to check for outliers in the residuals and other variables in the regression. I have a separate video on identifying outliers for which the link is included in the below description. For example, this histogram of standardized residuals indicate the presence of potential outliers. In the box plot also, we can see that there are 4 outliers. We can pay close attention to those observations to see whether they are genuine or normally expected observations. For this purpose, we need to investigate the distributions of independent variables and dependent variables. For example, when I investigate the independent and dependent variables, I found that credit risk with outliers variable contained 3 outliers. In other words, 3 of the outliers identified with the residuals has been identified as outliers under credit risk as well. Therefore, in this case, I remove these 3 extreme outliers from the analysis with the help of a selection variable. For example, now observation 9, 63, and 118 are crossed off. Then if we do the analysis again, we can see that our results have been improved. Histogram of the residuals looks normally distributed and the coefficients are almost equal to the expected values. Even though we cannot see the difference in the regression output, when the residuals become normally distributed, the p-values become smaller. For example, look at these p-values expressed in scientific format before removing outliers and after removing outliers. Another very common reason for the violation of this normality assumption is high diversity in the sample. In other words, the sample may not be homogeneous due to some uncontrolled factors. In this case, we can either divide the dataset into homogeneous subsets or exclude heterogeneous observations from the regression analysis. For example, I have fabricated this data set so that for the first 75 observations, the actual regression model is like this. For the rest of the 75 observations, the regression model is like this. See, the effect of credit risk is different in the two groups. In one, there is a positive effect, and in the other, there is a negative effect. As mentioned earlier, in practical situations, we do not know such information. Let's see if the regression analysis used in the same previous model is capable of estimating these coefficients accurately. For example, if I run the regression without knowing the existence of this sort of different relationships for two hidden groups in the dataset, I can observe that the overall regression model is not statistically significant and none of the coefficients are significant. Moreover, both histogram and normality tests reveal that the residuals are not normally distributed. This implies that the estimated coefficients and other statistics in this regression can be misleading since one of the assumptions has not been met. For example, now the estimated regression coefficients are not even close to the expected coefficients. This means that the regression analysis has failed to reveal the true relationships prevailing in the dataset. Since the residuals are not normally distributed, we need to start diagnosing the model. In this case, a closer look at the sample reveals that the sample consists of companies from two very different industries. In other words, the sample has not been controlled for industry. It is highly possible that the effect of these independent variables are different in the two industries. Therefore, it is very important to make sure that the sample is homogeneous in all aspects other than those explicitly accounted for in the regression model. For example, in this regression model, we need to make sure that the sample is homogeneous in all aspects other than credit risk, firm size, and leverage. If this is not the case, either we need to exclude one industry from our analysis so that all companies belong to one industry, or we have to regress these two industries separately so that in each regression we have a homogeneous subset of companies. In this example, I decided to regress these two industries separately. One easy method to do so is first add the variable into our dataset to indicate the industry. Here, I have used 0 to denote one industry and 1 to denote the other industry. Then I split the file based on this variable. For this, click Data, Split File. In this dialog box, select Organize Output by Groups and move industry variable here. We cannot see anything happen with this, but now the SPSS has divided the dataset into two subsets based on industry. When the file is split, all subsequent statistical analysis shall be performed separately and the output shall be displayed separately. Now I run regression. This time, for convenience, instead of saving the residuals, I click plots and then select histogram and normal probability plot here. Now when we click OK here, we can see that there are two sets of outputs, one for each industry. For example, this section shows the regression results for industry equals 0 and this section shows the results for industry equals 1. Now our residuals are approximately normally distributed and the two regression models are statistically significant. Further, the coefficients are almost equal to the expected values. This means this time the regression analysis has estimated the coefficients more accurately than in the previous case. Later, if we want to undo the split file, we can click Data, Split File. In this dialog box, select Analyze All Cases, Do Not Create Groups option, and then click OK. Now in the subsequent analysis, SPSS will consider entire dataset without any grouping. As a final thought, we need to remember that the real data rarely meets this normality assumption, particularly with relatively small samples. And we do not have to seriously worry about this assumption for very large samples, say larger than 200. In summary, if the residuals in the regression are not normally distributed, we have to rethink about the model specification and investigate other assumptions. In this video, I demonstrated how the outliers and diversity in the sample affect the residuals. I have separate videos showing how to test for other regression assumptions.